During the 1970s and 80s, Parker Stevenson was a Hollywood hunk who was one of the biggest stars. But acting wasn't Parker's first love, as Craig Bennett found out when he sat down with the actor, and a big thanks to The Hollywood Show for this Australian television exclusive. I'm gonna make you a star.
Parker Stevenson is the handsome heartthrob with the all-American good looks. Parker looked like a leading man from the moment he first stepped in front of a camera. But a career in showbiz wasn't what the New York native thought was in his future.
I had no interest in acting. None. Zip. None. I was studying architecture, and I was sure that's what I was going to do. And then somewhere along the line, I did a couple of pieces of work. I did one little movie called Lifeguard.
Rick Carlson?
Yeah.
I'm Chris Randall. I'm supposed to be helping you out on weekends.
That experience should fit everything. And by the time I graduated, I didn't want to do architecture anymore. I wanted to act.
Parker's mum had appeared on Broadway, and she helped to guide her son on the highs and lows of a life on stage and screen. He was soon making a living doing what he loved, but he puts his success down to one thing.
Luck.
I was flat till I went fluffy.
I grew up with a mother who had access to the industry, and I physically have a certain look, or I'm a certain type, and there were parts that line up, and I got lucky. I got lucky when I was getting commercials. I got lucky when I got the Hardy Boys.
It's here, it's the last entry, plus the name Sonny, Tuesday 2 a.m.
But I was the last person to read, and there was no particular reason that anybody else couldn't have gotten that part.
Sean Cassidy, he was cast first, as I understand.
Yes.
And was it to do with the fact that you and Sean just had that chemistry, the carrying on that kind of nabbed the gig for you?
I think you summed it up perfectly. He was the first person set, and I was the last person read. I still see Sean. We crack each other up. There's something about his sense of humor is really dry, and it's a humor that I really like, that I'm comfortable with, and it's just, I think that is what worked. Us fooling around, that's what we did, the back lot. We jump on the trams for the studio tour in the middle of a shot, and we'd tour around through a couple of streets and say hi to people and jump off, or not tell them we were on the back, and then tap them on the shoulder and say hi. And I mean, that is what our relationship is. It's loose and warm.
And fun. The Hardy Boys catapulted Parker into a level of celebrity he never imagined.
Has a touch of class.
He was determined not to be typecast as a teen heartthrob and was soon sharing the screen with and working for some of Hollywood's biggest names.
Good evening.
Including twice for the master of suspense, Alfred Hitchcock.
He was disdainful and distant, but an icon, you know? So those are the high points, you know? And I actually forget about a lot of those. But then the second episode I did, Bert directed.
Lean out a little bit further away, I'm gonna make a turn.
Bert is Burt Reynolds. The two became great friends after Bert handpicked Parker to play the villain in his racing flick, Stroker Ace. It was a friendship Parker holds very dear.
And then you have these moments where everything just comes together and you love the people you're working with and the work is good. You feel great about what you're doing, and that keeps you going through the hard times. Keeps you going when you're not working.
In 1989, Parker caught lightning in a bottle when he landed a leading role on what would become the biggest show of the decade.
It took me a little bit to realize that it was the best job in the world to go to work. And sometimes, you know, you're getting up at 5 a.m, you're driving, it's dark, and then you get there and the sun's coming up and you're looking at the Pacific and you're going, oh my God, I'm working?
I believe in fate. Do you?
Fate? Nah.
I did the first year, then NBC canceled it, and then they retooled the whole show, and I didn't go back to the show then.
Why not?
I just wasn't sure I wanted to do it. And I was running around in a red Speedo every day, and it's cold. And
I loved it.
Me too.
Well, well, well.
And Hasselhoff kept calling me and saying, come back and play, come back and play. And I thought about it. I thought, you know what? Don't be an idiot. You know these people. You love these people. You love David. Go play, you know, go do it. See what that experience
is. And you did.
I did, and I did a bunch, and I kept doing it. And then I went back on the show.
When his stint on Baywatch ended, Parker headed down under for a role.
I spent a couple months doing All the Rivers Run 2, which is a couple month miniseries down there, with great, great cast.
John
great
Waters. Experience.
John Waters, and we shot all over the place, and we shot in the Outback, and we shot up the Murray River, and we shot in Melbourne, and I really got to travel and spend time there. And they would take me to like the Australian rules football games. They take me to the horse racing. They take me to all of that stuff. It's like the best.
You're wearing UGG boots now.
I wear UGGs all the time. I live at the beach and I wear them all the time. People say, "Hi." No, they're hot.
Most newlyweds stay in their cabin for the whole cruise.
Parker had been a huge success on the screen. All that was missing was a significant other. That came when he met and married fellow actor Kirstie Alley. The couple remained together for 14 years and remained committed parents and grandparents.
Two kids now.
Yes.
And my son now has two kids.
So you're a granddad?
Yeah. Sweet, really wonderful. The Kirstie and I have that as a legacy. It's really a great gift. I'm grateful for that with her.
She did also leave a legacy in television when it comes to the Emmy Awards and that particular speech.
I'd like to thank my husband Parker, the man who has given me the big one for the last 8 years.
As I remember, what I said to her when we got in the car to go home was, "It's okay. Don't ever feel like you have to bring me up in an award ceremony again. It's fine. I'm really okay with that."
When Parker isn't filming, he's busy with his other passion, photography.
You know, as a kid, I was shooting with brownies and I was shooting on anything I could get my hands on. I liked looking. It's really probably more what it reflects. And that's what I did in New York when I was waiting for auditions or walking the city. You know, it helps you look and not just be in your head. Unlike film, it's not collaborative, really. Shooting portraits is collaborative, but shooting street photography or found objects or landscapes, it's a very private.
Parker's take on Hollywood is both refreshing and honest.
Burt Reynolds said to me once, "There are a lot of guys that are better looking and more talented than you or me, but they didn't hang in there." And that really is sort of what I always thought was probably the truth of it.
My only job here is to feed your curiosity.
With more than 45 years of acting under his belt and starring in the hit Netflix series Greenhouse Academy, Parker continues to hang in there.
I'm a presence now in a cast full of people that were my age when I was really starting to work a lot. That's nice, full circle.